Check your pet. Is their flea collar hurting, maybe even killing them? Well, tens of thousands of pet owners report theirs did, even though the feds approved the collars. Channel 11 News anchor Susan Copen here in the studio with us with the consumer complaints and what the EPA is now doing about them. Susan.
And David, although fleas and ticks are a threat to pets year-round, this time of year the nuisance becomes even greater, and our state sees a high number of tick-borne illnesses.
All right, Mr. Jones.
Tammy Shugart is watching her little chihuahua, Mr. Jones, closely. She has to because he can't see.
He got really sick after I put this collar on him in the fall. He started having problems with his salivary glands and then problems with his eyes.
She bought the collars at Walmart. These are the actual Seresto collars that she put on Mr. Jones and her other dog named Benson, who died from cancer.
It was heartbreaking when I thought about the collars and wondered if there was a link between the two.
Tammy is one of the more than 86,000 pet owners who filed a formal complaint with the Environmental Protection Agency after using Seresto collars. Mickey Hearn is another. She took this video of what happened to her dog, Buddy.
The whole area was covered with dried
pus.
I was furious that they just denied it. And not just for me, but for the thousands of other people.
Scientists say Seresto uses two powerful pesticides that spread through your pet's hair into their follicles and glands.
I don't think the testing for Seresto was adequate.
Karen McCormack is a scientist who used to work for the EPA, the agency that approved the Elanco-made Seresto collars for store shelves.
We were getting over 86,000 incidents for Seresto, which is a huge number of incidents.
She says the number of complaints should have been a red flag, but the EPA did nothing. Elanco sent us a statement saying, "We have policies to ensure any concerns related to their use are investigated and addressed as appropriate." Elanco unequivocally continues to stand behind the safety profile of Seresto.
99% of the information that EPA uses in their risk assessment comes from industry studies. They conduct the safety studies for their own pesticide products. Some people have said that it's like having the fox guard the chicken coop.
The EPA sent a statement saying it registered Seresto collars after determining the collars were safe for the treated pet and that the collars were effective against fleas and ticks. The label includes warnings about storage and disposal of the collars, but doesn't include anything about safety risks.
So these are very, very potent insecticides.
Nathan Donnelly is with the Center for Biological Diversity. The conservation nonprofit used the Freedom of Information Act to see the complaints and internal EPA emails.
It was really shocking. I can't imagine that the agency had so much information in front of it and yet did absolutely nothing with that information.
So Donnelly filed a petition with the EPA to pull Seresto collars. The EPA says it will make a decision after reviewing public input and evaluating additional information Elanco sent. Pet advocates like veterinarian Dr. Judy Morgan also want the collars banned. She says they are dangerous, not just for pets, but people too.
When you put a collar around your pet's neck, it's pretty hard to tell your toddler, don't touch that.
We've been seeing incidents of young children who sleep with dogs at night, waking up and in some cases having seizures and major rashes on their body.
Despite the tens of thousands of complaints, the collars are still sold in stores across America.
The EPA's approved this, it must be safe. Well, that's not necessarily true.
Elanco says the rate of incident reports for pets wearing Seresto collars is low and has been decreasing over time, less than a fifth of 1% reporting rate across the board. The collar maker says the data show no established link between the active ingredients in Seresto and pet death.
How many of our pets have to die before we say, hey, we have enough evidence?
Tammy Shugart showed us thousands she spent trying to save Benson and Mr. Jones, whose health is still at risk. So she recently got a rescue named Typhoon. Tammy says she wanted a little companion to help her when Mr. Jones passes. In the meantime, She has this advice.
I would tell them to look at Mr. Jones. And I would tell them about Benson and my loss with him and the cancer. And I would tell them to do the research, connect the dots.
So here's what to watch for. Vets say symptoms can include everything from vomiting and diarrhea to muscle tremors, seizures, and even a coma. Scientists and vets say there are plenty of natural options out there, like using a spray. Tammy Shugart switched to a collar that uses natural oils and says that it works great.